Okay. Hey guys, it's Phantom, and welcome or welcome back to my channel for part two of the Sims 4 live stream that I reacted to. So, part two of this reaction. The reason why I didn't do this all in one part was because the live stream was 2 hours long, and the first 2 hours took me literally all day, so I had to split it in two parts. So this is the second part. Anyway, let's continue on with this reaction.
Another cool object we have for kids is this bike. So I actually can't travel around or ride it. Why is that?
It's because I think you're a kid and you need to learn how to bike, Morgan. So one of the things that I think...
Oh, look, he just sabotaged his work rival.
Stuffed an old Harvest Fest skeleton into Bella's office drawer.
Funny story, that there's actually a skeleton in my old desk drawer at work.
Is this based...
Also, I don't know how many more minutes we have left of this. Because I stopped, like, in the middle. So, yeah.
Based on a true story.
Nice. Really, really putting the best bits of ourselves into this game. So for our kids, right, like our adults have bikes and our adults can kind of ride bikes already because they're grown up and they know how to do it. But with our kids, we felt like it.
Oh my gosh, this is so funny.
To be like our kids can just know how to ride a bike right off.
This is so funny. She looks like she's riding it. Like how you would ride, what are they called when bikes don't have any pedals? Or like pedalless bikes, I don't know what they're called, but. Yeah, it's basically the bikes that don't have any like pedal thing, like foot pedals.
Mm-hmm. Off the bat. And so they actually need to learn how to ride the bike. And once they've done that, once they've kind of mastered being able to ride a bike, then they can use it as a vehicle for traveling, much like our adults can. Mm-hmm. So then they can kind of ride it around, and they can take it to different lots and stuff like that. But we also added some cool things with, it's a milestone if we mm-hmm. can get Kara there. your bare head does not want to stay
out. It does not.
We also, I think, to make it so that, because kids' bikes are cooler, kids' everything is cooler, right? Mm-hmm. If you go to the store and you're like buying an adult version of something versus a kid's version of something, kids' version of things are cooler. What's really cool about these kids' bikes, I think we have 6 new kids' bikes with variants.
Yeah, I agree with that. When you're younger, when you're a kid, everything is like new and fun and amazing and yeah.
What's cool is that each of the kids' bikes have like slightly different accessories, and so you can see this one has a horn. I think maybe this one has a light as well. If it was nighttime, we would see it shining. But there's like a horn and a light and like a noisemaker that can change even the way that it sounds when you're riding it. And depending on which kids' bike you buy, it has like a different kind of configuration of those sort of upgrades or accessories on the bike.
We also have some adult bikes as well. Yep. So adults have some bikes in this pack they can ride too.
Yeah, can ride together. I think adults can help their kids like, learn how to ride a bike, right? And that can be a milestone as well.
While you're trying,
we actually got bikes in the Discover University pack, but I guess they added more bikes. So
to learn your bike, you can sometimes hit your head and make your tooth fall out.
Oh right, loose teeth.
You can actually
see. Does she have a loose tooth right now?
She does. I cheated it right now, so that's why it has that because I cheated it on. But, okay, yeah.
Ron's going for it.
Yeah, he's just sabotaging. I set him to sabotage work rival at work. Mm-hmm. He could also befriend them. So, I mean, anyways. But she, so she has a loose tooth, so we could wiggle it. But, let's go ahead and just pull it out.
Oh, hardcore. All right. All right, so now your tooth is out.
Yeah.
Kara no longer has a loose tooth, but now has like a missing tooth.
And we get her to smile here. We could see it.
Yes.
Open your mouth. Where are you going?
You'll never see it.
I'll never see it. Well, she has a tooth gap there where she lost her tooth. It's there.
being very uncooperative. But you have a loose tooth now, and you can take that tooth, and you can, if you were to click on, like, her bed, for example, or, you now can place the tooth under the pillow and go to sleep, and when she wakes up, she'll be able to...
It's time to hide the bed. You'll find a nice surprise from the tooth fairy.
And so when she wakes up, then you'll get kind of a nice little moment of a lost tooth fairy time.
I think she got a milestone. She got some new reward objects.
Yeah. And some money as well.
Some money as well.
Right. Yeah, and this is like when we're talking about milestones, right? Like you get a cute little kind of like tooth certificate for your first tooth that you lost.
Yeah. I know a good place we could potentially put that tooth certificate. Maybe we check out these.
Oh, these little boxes?
Mm-hmm, these little boxes. We have three of them, kind of an ornate one. We have a kind of a cheapskate. I don't know who named
cheap
that.
Cheapskate?
Workplace rival.
Keepsake box.
Cheapskate, keepsake box, yes.
And a basic one.
Yes.
This is an elder sim, so she's able to designate this keepsake box as their family keepsake box.
These keepsake boxes are one of my favorite things in this pack because they're small. There's not, you know, they're not
the lumber box.
But when I talked about our milestones and the kind of decorative objects you got from the milestones, one of the things that I really love about this pack when I've been playing with it is that you really get to inject this sense of history with this pack that we haven't had an opportunity to do before. And our keepsake boxes, I think, are a great example of that, which is, as an elder, you can designate that this keepsake box, and you can rename it, right, is sort of the family keepsake box, is the memento that you want to pass on. And then one of the really cool things that you can do is you can then, if you are close enough with somebody else in your family, is you can then... pass that on to that family member.
That's so smart.
Through that, you can have this sense of an object that has meaning for the family and is able to be, is able to kind of like keep that meaning through generations, right? And you can see that it's also like a little kind of storage box. So you can put cool things into it. You can put things that have meaning, maybe milestones things, or maybe just like something that you think has meaning for the family, and be able to put that in it. And then the other interaction that's on here, ponder the meaning of family, is a fun little kind of interaction that lets you mess with family dynamics a little bit. So it lets you like use the power of kind of the legacy of your family to change a dynamic that might be set that you might not like right now.
You might also be seeing in her inventory, she has a friendship bracelet that was made by her. And Kara actually also has one.
Oh, okay.
This is a new object called the Friendship Bracelet Kit. And you can click on that to make friendship bracelets. We have some different ones
cool.
that are all really cute you can make. And we also updated it. So if you have like Nifty Knitting, you can do it here.
Table.
Or you can do an activity table. Or
and like the knitting basket from Nifty Knitting. Yes.
I think the crochet box as well.
Oh, cool.
The
cross stitch. Yeah.
And so those are also objects you can do that. But we have to have a friend.
Right. So if you each have made a friendship bracelet, you can then exchange them.
Or if it's a sim in another household, they don't have to necessarily have made
sure.
one.
Okay.
But because they both live in the same household, we made them.
Okay.
So
Mama
them.
And Kara are going to exchange friendship bracelets here.
Yeah, they are. So so Kara's going to come here and exchange it. Slow this down. She says, you want to exchange friendship bracelets? You'd want to give me a friendship bracelet?
Boom.
Of course.
Look at that. Super cute. So they've exchanged friendship bracelets.
And you can see it on their hands now.
Oh yeah, you can see it on their wrists, and they have each other, right?
Kara, and hers was made by Mama now.
Nice.
And they both have it on their hands. And they'll eventually get worn out and fall off.
Okay.
But for now they have them.
They have a special friendship bond. I think we added another really cool kind of like interaction that you can do while you're wearing each other's friendship bracelet.
I think it's under affection?
Yeah,
bracelet buddy
fist bump.
If you do this, Kara has another friend, and if she were to do this in front of Gonzalo, And Zolo might get kind of jealous.
Oh, right, because he's like, why didn't I get a friendship bracelet? Why are you doing this bracelet buddy fist bump with somebody else?
You know, like, I thought I was your friend.
Right.
So we were pretty close.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because you can only exchange friendship bracelets with one sim, right?
Yes.
That's the rule. That's the rules of friendship.
You can also demand your friendship bracelet.
Well, I would. That's malicious.
It happened
I don't know
to
if
be
I would.
In school when I was a child.
Uh-huh. You were saying that you exchange friendship bracelets with someone, and mm-hmm. then they demand. Look, oh my! I cannot believe that you did that with Kara.
No, she's gonna have this memory with her grandma forever.
So
sad. She was hurt.
Would you give her a hurt sentiment?
But yes, this happened to me, and I'm still
okay.
hurt as an
yeah.
adult. So.
And then you
should probably last with her forever. Yeah. You should probably forever remember.
When Kara grows up to be a game developer and is doing a stream, she'll be like, remember that time that my grandmother demanded the friendship?
And then I went to work, and they made me take the feature and friendship bracelet that made me remember that really sad moment in my childhood, and
yeah.
I worked on it.
So really, I understand it's a really personal connection there. I think friendship bracelets are cool. I think you could tell some cool stories there, as you can see. And then some really cool touches in terms of being able to wear them.
Some other things to show off. We've got this play mat that they can play on. Over here, we have a diaper changing table. Let's see if we can have her just use her diaper really quick.
Use their diaper recently, right?
Yeah. And if she uses her diaper, then we can actually change her diaper. And this also works for toddlers who have changed their diaper as well.
Mm-hmm.
But not for Delaney, because Delaney's potty trained.
Okay.
I mean, she is, if she used her diaper,
sure.
she can still do it.
Yeah.
She's not
she
changing, because she's a big girl now.
She's, these changing tables are really cool. The thing that I really like is that you see there's a little, kind of like diaper pail, trash can. You got the pee on caregiver milestone.
Woo!
Nice. Is that some of these milestones are just a little bit sillier. Is that the diaper pail trash can is kind of like
mm-hmm.
right next to it, is attached to it. What happens is if you have that attached to your changing table, is the diaper automatically gets put in there.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have to worry about diaper trash. If you don't, then the diaper shows up on the floor. You have to clean it up eventually, or maybe Kyle will take care of it while he's here or something like that. But that's, I think, a cool little touch with our changing tables.
Another thing... just see if we can teleport her there. You let me cheat?
I don't know if she's being carried.
She's
in the high chair.
Let's have her let her out really quick.
Okay.
Mentioned we would show off what you can do here with these baby-proofing things, but so this is baby-proofed. And you can see she can try to break loose now.
Mm-hmm.
So that's like a fun way to play with wild toddlers.
Right.
Who may
like
succeed
even
or may
if you
not
baby-proof something, right? There's a chance that they have a breaking out.
Yeah. So that's pretty fun. She did not succeed.
She did.
Oh,
she did. She's out.
Oh, she can't be
detained. So that's cool. That's a cool kind of like little baby-proof and gate thing.
Mm-hmm.
So
let's go ahead and we also have some other cool objects around here. We have this celebration cannon.
We have too much stuff.
That might be good for some events
mm-hmm.
we could talk about.
Yeah, we have 3 new events. I don't know if we have time to actually do them in the stream,
mm-hmm.
But we have 3 new events, which are a baby shower.
Mm-hmm.
And that is something that we wanted to make available kind of for all of our new baby stories. So you don't need a pregnant sim to have a baby.
So we finally get baby showers. I think there was a mod for like a baby shower back then. There was like mods for, there was a prom mod, there was a baby shower mod, there was a funeral mod. I don't know, but now we don't have to have mods for baby showers anymore. That's cool.
Baby shower, right? Maybe you're telling an adoption story, or something like that. We have a new family reunion.
Oh, yeah, if we wouldn't be able to remove ourselves from the screen for a moment, I kinda
surprised
and did this out of order. I'm sorry.
A family reunion event and a slumber party event. And the slumber party event also kind of shows off our new, I was going to gonna say shows off, but really, like, it's useful to use with our new sleeping bags. Mm-hmm. I know that we probably want to look at some other places in the world, so I don't know how much we want to go into any of these in particular, but they're all really cool events that kind of are, again, helping you tell the story of a new kind of member of the household joining, whether you have kids that are kind of like wanting to throw a little party of their own and have a sleepover. That slumber party can be held in the home, can be held in certain venues as well to have like the lock-in effect of like we're in the, you know, we're out and like having a sleepover somewhere else, and a family reunion that is sort of gathering, you know, makes a thematic sense of gathering the family together. But that canon is, I think, useful at any event that you might throw, potentially is a good celebratory object for something like a baby shower.
And you might have noticed that I could also add these events and throw them while we have somebody staying over. So
that's right. So
that's one of the nice things. Is
the
like,
stayover doesn't stop you.
So you could be like, hey, Mom and Dad, come stay with us, and then while they're over, you can throw a
family
reunion.
Yeah, totally.
As a reward for the family reunions, you also get these really awesome picture frames that I've filled in with pictures of our family from our various places.
Oh, these are so cool. These are one object, right? But they're like collage frames, so each of the little frames can contain a different photo that you put in there. And I feel like
that is such
an easy way to kind of customize your lot with decoratives with pictures, and so yeah, these are awesome. But these, like you said, these are rewards from the family reunion event.
So it's kind of late at night. Let's go ahead and have Ron and Mira go out together for like a late night date night to the Anchor Paint Point. We'll go here to our new library. This one was built by Deligracy. And we'll take a look around this neighborhood. Do you want to tell us a little bit about the Anchor Point Wharf, Rach?
Hey, yeah, I'm happy to, although I'm still emotionally recovering from Kyle Kyleson starting a fire. I just needed to say, I think that is Sim Guru Connor's finest design moment. Not the fire, just Kyle. But anyway, so here's Anchor Point Wharf, and we were kind of thinking about this as feeling a little bit closer to that city vibe that we wanted. So a lot of the buildings here kind of look like they've been reclaimed. When I pointed out Bayani Robles before in the prior neighborhood,
he's one of
those founding fathers. We thought of him as somebody who is kind of creating the fishing trade in this area and canning, and it kind of built up from there. The Robles family is still present.
Look at that. That looks so pretty, doesn't it?
See them in another neighborhood, but their family house is, the main one is down here. My favorite thing about this is I wanted this to feel like kind of you could see the original house and then the addition as this family kept expanding out. I felt like that was really emblematic of this pack, just watching as your family grows and grows and you're trying to figure out what to do there. So that's their lot. And then let's see, what else do we have here? We have a nice little square area where there's a piano that you can come out and play. There is a food stand that you can visit. Yeah, I love this food stand so much. So you can stop by, get a little bit to eat, get some samosa, and go from there. And let's see, I think the main thing, aside from the library, which I also just love because it's so family friendly, we have a little area set up for parents. And oh, is that Bernice playing piano?
Yeah. I love it. One of our pre-mates,
hey,
one
Bernice.
Of our Robles family.
Yay! I love this piano too. I play piano, so this is huge for me. But yeah, let's take a look then at this date night area, the movie theater. This is one of my favorite things because we kind of just kicked around an idea of, well, you should be able to see a movie here. And that blossomed into this entire experience, which is being able to see a variety of genres together or by yourself. Yeah, it looks like we're going to go pick out something romantic because it is a date, isn't it? You can see different genres reflected on the outside and with the sound as well. And when you go into this theater, while you're not able to see it yourself, things do happen in there. There may be some riveting events that take place when you're there. Sorry, I'm so bad at puns. I'll stop. That's the only one, I swear. But yeah, just, you know, chance to kind of get a movie and see how you feel about it. Let's see how they feel.
And you saw that there are different genres of movies. I also, I know that, like, depending on your Sim's personality, there are different chances that they may like or dislike certain genres.
Like, a Sim that doesn't like children isn't going to like this child family movie. But like a Sim who likes romance is probably going to be pretty down for Pax and Prejudice, which turned into
a
movie.
They adapted it. That was a book, right? Yeah.
Yes. It always makes makes me think of the Sims 3 movie theater, which is really nostalgic for me. So that's nice, I think. And I love the way this lights up at night.
Yeah, they did a really good job with the Sims 3 movie theater.
You can also see the fog rolling off the bay at night, which I think is really cool and also amazing. And the way this like bridge lights up and you can see all the cars on it.
All right, so they came out of this movie.
So she liked it.
Oh, swoons galore.
I think it looks like he liked it, too.
What a successful date night.
Oh, look at that. Them.
Yeah.
Aww.
And they say romance is dead.
It's not.
All you gotta go, you just gotta go watch an adaptation of a Jane Austen starring werewolves.
I wanted to show off this library, too, because we have a lot of new assets here that are really great for children libraries. Like these bookshelves, which are interlockable. This is like an end to this bookshelf, so you could build it like that. Upstairs, we have more of these bookshelves and like different layouts. And Deli did a great job building this library here. That's like a really cool family friendly one.
Yeah.
You can see our new changing table here. It's like a public changing table.
Oh, yeah, the ones that kind of fold down from the side, from the wall.
That's super cool.
Yeah.
And like a little nursing room here for the infants. And I think, and this awesome little play area. I think it's a great library. Okay. So let's go ahead and travel to the other neighborhood as well.
Got one more neighborhood, right?
Hmm?
And this one contains, I think, a new, taking everyone.
The firemen too. Okay. We'll just bring our family.
Contains our new venue.
Hmm? Do you want to tell us about this neighborhood as well, Rach?
Yeah, I would be happy to. We'll talk about the venue in a second, but once we load in, I just want to talk in general about Gilbert Gardens, which is, I mentioned before, we talked about Old Stumpy and mentioned that that was, you know, the last remnant of our sequoias. Our friend Gilbert Gilberts is responsible for the deforestation of San Sequoia. This park area, I was kind of thinking about it as his estate that he so graciously gifted to everyone after he passed away. So you can kind of see his old house here. There's a nice little lake here where you can fish and, yes, swim and do more. You can even walk around it. You might want to keep your eyes peeled for White Claw the Crocodile. I don't know, he might not be out right now, but, you know, be wary. Be wary.
Oh, maybe there.
We'll just see the bubbles now, but you know. Yeah, never know. So, yeah, again, there's a little space where you can do some group walking, and let's see, over here by the rec center, we'll go back to it in a sec. The splash pad.
Oh,
so
man.
This is, this is one of my favorite things in the world. We have to zoom in on my buddy Whalebert over there. Yeah, Whalebert.
Yeah, fast forward so maybe it can be morning by the time. I'm sorry, the timing wasn't great.
That's all right. You know,
Whalebert looks good in any light.
He does. He's the star of this pack.
But we wanted to kind of create this sort of family-friendly thing and just a little splash pad that kind of grew into a big splash pad, honestly, where you can play in the water, watch it, obviously stomp playfully. It might be a great place to bring your dog, I think. I don't know. Just if you're up for that.
Even an infant if you're holding it?
Yes, even an infant if you're holding it.
Yeah, so, we didn't get a chance to at our home lot because there was just so much to look at.
Mm-hmm.
This is obviously for this neighborhood sort of like bespoke. Our environment team put this together. It looks incredible. But what's really cool is I think almost all of these pieces that you see here are available in the catalog, and you home or on another venue can set it up kind of how you want, right? Each of these kind of like taller, mushroom ones.
Even different mats that are different
that
shapes and different colors.
Yeah, and
you can like design your own for your own lots. It's really cool.
Yeah, so this is not just like, this isn't the only splash pad, right? Like you can create one at home, but you can also, you have the ability to customize based on all of these pieces, which I think is also really, really nice.
Yeah, it's just, it's a little bit of extra fun if you like that sort of thing, and I hope you do. So yeah, let's move away from that splash pad, and I want to go to the rec center now. I want to talk about rec center.
Let's go look at that.
Yeah.
So this one was built by Lil Simpsy.
Yeah, and so what I wanted to go for here was, I come from a smaller town where you kind of wanted a central place to do everything, and that's what I was hoping for. So you could come here to make art, play musical instruments. You can come here to work out if you want, just hang out. It's great to book for an event if you wanted to. I know Scott already talked a little bit about some of the events that we can have here. If you wanted to book a lock-in, this is your spot for it. And yeah, there are the instruments, and of course the clown painting, which was super important for me to add. I may be a bit of a clown freak, but we won't talk about that today. So what I really want to zoom in on...
Love another full stream for that.
Yeah, gotta save that for another day. Those game tables, though. So one of my favorite things we added this are symbols and puzzles. I really wanted to create an area especially for elders to come to and socialize, hang out, and just do whatever they want. So obviously there's a chessboard, but this is mainly for me about the symbols and the puzzles. If you wanted to show that off.
Did you say puzzles?
Oh, did I jump the gun? Yes, puzzles.
So they're playing symbols right here, but they can actually change the game to cards. And I think there's some others if you have other packs. Mm-hmm. But also puzzles, which is my favorite to do here. So let's have her, she changed the game to puzzles, and we can actually choose a puzzle. Okay. There are a lot of them.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of puzzles.
Different categories, different sizes, but I saw an option here, custom puzzle from reference.
Yes, this is delightful, so we'll do that.
So this allows you to, take a, take a picture, like our kind of paint by reference, right? Mm-hmm. And then... that becomes a puzzle that your sim works on. And then when you finish it, it'll look like that picture that you took.
Yeah. So she stopped doing that. Oh, she's going to keep doing it. And we're going to have her, while she's doing this, there's a mischief interaction.
Okay.
We're going to have Kara steal a piece.
Oh, Kara's going to come over.
Yeah.
And take one.
Yeah, she's a little bit mischievous here. So she's going to come and steal a puzzle piece. While they're working on it.
Oh, okay.
Swipe it.
Yeah.
Nobody saw.
Yeah. Got a piece now.
Yeah. And they're going to keep working on this. Something I love about the rec center is while I feel like I'm here, I regularly have kids and come by.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's
like
a nice kids area.
It's
yeah.
a nice place
it
to
really
meet other
kids. It
really
is a place kind of for like for families for all ages. Like there's a lot of stuff that you can just kind of hang out and do here.
I'm going to fast forward because I want to see it made.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, good. Yeah, I wanted it to be really just for all ages appropriate. And I think Lil Simsy just did an amazing job building this one. And I hope that there's a lot that everyone else can do when they're making their own if they wish to. But, yeah, just something
Look
for
at Nancy. Oh, my God.
While they're building, I forgot to mention something kind of important. It actually popped up earlier with Kyle Kyleson. But I wanted to highlight that I mentioned lore a couple times when I was talking. If you're somebody who's really into lore, I am, you can run the Share Sequoia Secrets interaction on mm-hmm. some of our premades if you want to learn a little bit more about them. There's some stuff that I put in. I had hinted before about the Michelsons with the name. If you're a little bit curious to know what's going on there, you can kind of run that to find out more about Celeste's history in particular. It's really important to me personally. And also just for everybody else, if you want to learn details about the Sims themselves or the area, that's the way to do it.
Nice. They're done here, but it looks like
there's a
because
piece that
she
was stolen.
Stole the piece, there's a piece missing. So you can still like frame it and you can be like, we're done, right? Like put it up, I guess. But she still has the piece. Can Kara?
She did. And she got stole the finish.
Okay, so she put it back. It's
we
a full puzzle
frame
now.
It.
Yeah. And you can see that there's that lovely puzzle from reference that now you have.
And you can put it on the wall. You can put it in your keepsake box.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool. Do we want to... I don't know that there's too much more...
I did want to show off the walking path.
Yes. Okay. Let's send them for a walk.
So I'm going to teleport them over here just to get them here quickly. So this is something that's really fun we added for elders. Around this neighborhood, there are three different walking paths. You can see them on their signs here. But you can choose to, is she leaving?
I think she was running off.
Don't leave, please.
And she was already starting a walk. They have their own ideas.
Okay, so we're gonna do this right now. But there are three different of these paths around this neighborhood you mm-hmm. can find with different length of trails.
I think Kara ran off to do something, so you might need to wait for her to come back.
Maybe she's
walking already. There's one around the lake, right, which is kind of the biggest one. There's one around the pond, which is the smallest one, and then there's this middle-sized one about around the arboretum.
I think Grandma started without her. She's like, I'm done waiting. But they'll go for these power walks, and you can do this as a group. I would suggest Well, not while they're leaving the neighborhood already, but they'll kind of stop along the way and drink or stretch, mm-hmm. and then also I wanted to show out that, like, while she was doing this,
yeah, she's gonna go around this kind of, like, bend here.
They react to the neighborhood with, like, some of these certain things. So, like, here they've got the fun topiary, so they'll get a buff for that.
Yeah, yeah.
If I'm not talking very much during this, it's because I'm paying attention.
Yeah, so, like, there are special points around each of these neighborhoods, mm-hmm. where if you're near them, I think there's one near, like, Old Stumpy, potentially, mm-hmm. Where you'll get a sense of just, like...
statue.
Yeah. Kind of the points that might put your sim in a certain mood, but also just, like...
I love how there's so much more to do, honestly. Like, you can go more places, you can do more things... Growing together is definitely a path that I would play with. If I'm being honest. So, yeah.
Give them a little bit of sense of location.
Yeah, like a way that they're reacting. Another thing I think would be neat to mention, let's see if I can leave him.
Okay.
Bring him here. Is we didn't really show this, but they have made a self-discovery.
Oh, right. Yeah, this is one of those things where it's like, it's a little bit random, or it's not quite random, yeah. But there's stuff going on in the background, and we just didn't get a pop-up.
I was hoping we would get a pop-up during the stream.
But self-discovery is really cool. You might be, maybe you noticed, where you look at Ron and his traits, and you might be like, wait a second.
That's a lot of traits.
Does he have... This is soul music is. I love it. He's got an extra trait, doesn't he? And that's because with our new self-discovery system, and again, I wish that it had just kind of popped up so we could show it, but again, you know, it's a simulation. You have moments, depending on how you're playing your sim and what they're doing, mm-hmm. that behind the scenes we're sort of tracking that, and there are moments when it can pop up and say the game... That how you've been playing Ron, for example, and mm-hmm. says, what did he discover here? This was,
he got ambitious.
So it might have been when he got promoted or something. Okay. And so, like here, Ron might have gotten promoted, and at that point, the game would be like, oh, it seems like Ron was promoted, or Myra got perfectionist from...
I think she had got a skill to 10.
Okay, so when she got a skill to 10, there are moments where the game reacts to that, and it's like, hey, it seems like your sim did this thing. Does that mean maybe they're... this trait, mm-hmm. and it gives you a pop-up that allows you to accept it or not, so you can be like, no, I'm not playing them that way. But it also is another way that growing together allows your sims to sort of evolve, and the game gives you these great opportunities to say, hey, it seems like you're playing your sims this way. Maybe you want to add this family dynamic. Maybe you want to add this new trait. Maybe mm-hmm. you want to add this like or dislike based on what's happening right now. And I think this is really cool because it just adds this personality trait to your sim. Another thing that can happen is if you have, like, opposite personality traits, if you have a slob and you end up cleaning up a lot, the game might be like, you're not really playing this sim like a slob. Do you want them to be neat instead? I'll get rid of slob for you and I'll put in neat instead. And I think that's really cool, again, in terms of, like, growing together, allowing your sims to grow and evolve in a way that we haven't really done before. I think through self-discovery, your sim can gain up to a total of the cap is like 6 total personality traits that they can get. So they can get 3 more through self-discovery.
Yeah, it's fun for story.
Yeah.
And just playing the game and seeing how things go with it. I've really enjoyed this and, like, finding the different ways you unlock them. I think... So, that seems like a pretty good overview of our path.
So yeah, that's the end of the, that's the end of the stream. I had to do this in 2 separate parts again because the stream is 2 hours long and I didn't have the patience to sit for... I didn't have the patience to sit for 2 hours, so I just did it in 2 separate parts.
Growing together.
Yeah, there's so much in this pack. I am so excited for people to get their hands on it and start playing with it. I think, like, it... deepens your relationships, it makes your family matter more, it gets drama in your game, it makes all of your sims feel better. I think it's hard to go back to playing without this pack once you've played with this pack. It's gonna release worldwide March 16th. You can get it on EA app for PC, you can get it on Origin if you're on Mac, You can get it on Xbox, on PlayStation. We're everywhere now. I think it's on Steam. It's on Epic Game Store. You can message me and be like, send me a copy. And I won't. I'll tell you where to get it. But I can point you to the right places. But and then the Infant update comes out 2 days before on March 14th. I think that's our stream for today. For everyone. That's for everyone. On all those same platforms as well.
Yeah. So thank you for joining us. This was, there's even more than we got through, but
I think we did pretty well.
I think we did pretty good.
The water
bottle. Pretty good.
Thank you. Thank you for being the one controlling all of our Sims today, Morgan. Thank you all for being here. Thank you, Frost, for keeping us on time.
Bye.
Hey.
Okay, so that was the end of the stream. Okay, so that's the end of the stream. I'm gonna edit this later, not right now, but later. And I'll probably upload this today, or maybe, oh wait, no, not tomorrow. I don't upload on weekends. So I might upload this later, or if I don't upload this today, I will upload it Monday. So I hope you guys enjoyed the second half of this reaction. If you did, be sure to leave a like, comment, and please subscribe to the channel for more videos. And of course, I will leave the link. Of course, I will leave the link in the description. I will leave a link to their Twitch in the description because that's where I reacted to this at. It's easier for me. So, anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, be sure to leave a like, comment, and please subscribe. If you want me to do any other stream reactions, just let me know. Because there's a lot of streams I could react to. So, yeah. Anyway, that is all. Anyway, that is all for this. And I'll catch you in the next video. Bye, guys.